your girl Brie, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna show you guys a vlog slash story time of my 21st birthday. In case you guys didn't know, my birthday recently passed on February 17th, hashtag Aquarius. Your girl turned the big 2-1 and I was very excited. I had such an amazing time and I received a lot of cool gifts. For my 21st birthday, it was really great because I got to go to the Key West to Smathers Beach and I had such an amazing time with my friends and we really tried our best to vlog the whole time, but the only thing is we were kind of trying to live in the moment at the same time, so it was really hard trying to do both. So I managed to piece together a little something something you guys already saw in the beginning before this video, and you'll see also a little clip at the end of my quote unquote cinematic vlog that I'll try to create, so bear with me. Alright guys, so for my birthday weekend, I did a whole bunch of stuff. The actual day before my birthday, on that Saturday, I spent the whole day basically with my family. So the first place we went to was this really cute breakfast place in Miami. I loved it so much. The pancake I ate was literally like the size of my head, if not bigger, but honestly it was really good. They served like really big portions and I love the fact that the place was focused on being like really healthy, you know, with organic, wheat free, no calories, and surprisingly that kind of stuff sometimes can taste good, especially when drenched with maple syrup. But anyway, I had some really great food and I took some bomb pictures. Y'all, I wore this really cute Fashion Nova outfit. Literally everything I wore that day was Fashion Nova head to toe. I wore these really cute Fashion Nova glasses, this cute purple top, also with these really nice jeans and my clear heels. It was literally a moment because, you know, my hair was late, my nails was late, my eyebrows was on fleek, and my lashes, honey, they were there. I really felt so beautiful and I had such a great time, you know, just sit down with my family and eat breakfast. It was honestly a great way to start my birthday weekend, I guess you could say. So after breakfast, we went on home and my family like decorated one of the rooms in my house and sang me happy birthday with this cute little birthday cake that said 21 on it. And I opened up all of the amazing gifts that they got me. I'm actually gonna do a whole separate video showing you guys what I got for my 21st birthday, so be on the lookout for that. But anyway, I felt so happy and like blessed, period, to receive anything and for them to care about me and stuff. And I was just like, oh, my family loves me a little bit, a little bit. So after I opened up my gifts, we headed on to Miami to go to the Vizcaya Museum, which y'all, I have to say, that is literally one of the most beautiful places I have ever been in my life. So it's a museum and a garden as well. So like the inside of the museum is filled with beautiful sculptures and it shows you guys like the actual rooms that people used to live in as well as the bathrooms. And it's just really nice to see like, you know, the way that people used to live, because just about every room we went in, you didn't see anything like TVs, laptops, cell phones, none of that existed back then. So it's just like, what did they do for fun? I don't know, communicate with each other. Along with the beautiful museum on the inside, the outside was so nice, you guys. It was a beautiful garden. And when I tell you, there were so many people there who were taking wedding photos, baby photos, or having their actual wedding there. So of course, you know, your girl had to flick it up one time for the one time. I took pictures in the museum, all over the garden, all over the waterfront, because actually the museum is built like right before the water. So you could go outside and see like the whole ocean. And it was just so beautiful. I'm like, wow. Someone really lived like this? Like, this is literally amazing. So I definitely feel like if you guys live in Miami, it should be like on your bucket list to go to the Vizcaya Museum. It is definitely something that was worth doing. So after we went to the museum, we just headed back on home. Then after a couple hours of chilling, my family took me to one of my fave restaurants, Benihana's. So Benihana's is a restaurant down here where they cook and prepare the food in front of you. And I like it a lot because it's just something about having the meal prepared in front of you and the chefs do all cool tricks and stuff to entertain you, which I thought just gives you like a whole different type of restaurant vibe experience rather than, you know, just sitting down, ordering food, waiting for it to come, making small talk. And I actually happened to tell a guy it was like my birthday the next day because he kind of asked, he was like, oh,
are there any special events or occasions happening?
And I was like, hey, yo, my guy, my birthday's tomorrow. And he was like,
oh, it's lit.
So after we finished our food and everything, they kind of surprised me and brought out like a ice cream little birthday cake and had some candles in it. And they all sang me happy birthday in English and then in Japanese as well, which was, wow. Have you ever heard anyone say happy birthday in Japanese or sing the song, let alone? Yeah, it's a mouthful. And then I blew out the candles for it, and honestly, I was just really happy at that moment. I was like, you know, I'm in a good place right now. Because not only is the start of my birthday so great and it's not even my birthday yet, but also, you know, that little ice cream birthday cake was on the house. So I was like, hey, you know, free food. I'm all down for it, always and forever. So after Benihana's, we were trying to go back home, and it actually struck midnight while I was in the car on the way back home. So I kind of brought in like my 21st birthday officially while I was in the car. It wasn't ideal, but hey, it was whatever. It didn't really matter too much to me. But as soon as I got home, I went ahead and put in a really cool bath bomb and put on a really cool face mask from Mush. I sat in the bathtub to help bring in my 21st birthday, and I watched a couple shows on my laptop. And while I was doing all that, I was like, yo, this is me living my best life right now. Like, this is what dreams are made of. This is what dreams are made of. Like, I wasn't really doing much, but just sitting there in peace and serenity, I was like, hey, my birthday is off to just like an amazing start, y'all. This is great. So after that, I had to like kind of rush and get ready for Key West because the hours were going by super quick, which by the way, I got no rest on the day of my birthday. So I got home at like midnight, and then it took me a long time to just do the bath bomb and the face mask. And then I had to hurry up and pack for Key West. I had to pack for the day, bring a bunch of stuff, put a cute face of makeup on, get my hair looking cute and everything. Honestly, I just didn't have any time to sleep. And so later on about like 6 a.m., I went on down and pick up my friend so we can head on down to Key West. And thankfully, my friend Isabella, she drove the whole 4 hours, which honestly, y'all, we gonna give her a round of applause because she is the real MVP. She drove that whole entire 4 hours without getting tired. I was like, yo, how'd she do that? You know, I ain't gonna ask many questions. I'm just gonna let her do that. And actually, the trip to Key West is an adventure all in itself because it took us 4 hours to get there. And I know it's pretty long, but it was a really great time for us to sit in the car and, you know, self-reflect and talk to each other about things that we want to talk about and stuff. And for like a good hour, we were on this really long bridge that led from Florida to the Florida Keys. And it was a really great moment because the scenery was so beautiful. We were surrounded by water. The Florida Keys water was just so mesmerizing. It had like a really nice aqua color to it, and it looked more sparkling and clear, and I was here for it. I was like, y'all, this water is cute or whatever. So fast forward to when we actually got to Key West, it was really cool because my friend Isabella, she took us to this really nice breakfast place that she knew about over there, and it was really nice because the food there, y'all, it was exquisite. Like, when they brought out our food, I was like, y'all, this is definitely an Instagrammable moment. Like, I know we're all about to be millennials and whip out our phones and take pictures of our meals, but honey, this right here is totally Instagrammable, y'all. So after we ate breakfast, we went on down to Duval Street, which by the way is probably like one of the busiest streets in the Florida Keys, period. It was really nice because it was filled with like a lot of bars and souvenir shops. And of course, since I was 21, my friends dragged me to a bar. Personally, like, I am not anyone who drinks at all. And it's not because I think drinking is like bad. Like, come on now, if you can hold your liquor,
then you good, sis.
But drinking is just not for me because I just am a really picky person. So I don't like the smell of alcohol, let alone the taste. But of course, since you already know, peer pressure exists. So my friends dragged me to a bar and they had me get my first ever drink. My friend paid for it, by the way. He was like, yo, get her this drink, the drink with the least amount of liquor. And I was like, yes, please and thank you. So she was like, hey, can I see your ID? And I was like, yes, that's who you got. And she's like, oh, it's her 21st birthday, you guys. And I was like, yes, make a big deal, make a big deal. Stop, stop. I mean, continue. So I got my first drink. It was really coconutty. So with me not being a fan of alcohol and not a fan of coconut, I really didn't like the drink at all. So I was like, it's a no. But being in the bar in general was really nice. I thought it was a really cute moment, and being just at like the actual bar on the stool sitting there, I was just like, hey y'all, I'm wiggle. I don't drink, but
I'm wiggle.
After we spent a little while at the bar, we went back down Duval Street and headed down to Smathers Beach. So the reason why I went to Key West in general was to go to Smathers Beach. We bought like a full day of excursions type deal on the beach, and it was pretty cool. The first thing we did was go parasailing, which by the way, you guys, if you have never gone parasailing, you better. Going parasailing is an extremely cool thing because you're up in the sky, way up, so you get a beautiful view of the Florida Keys as well as a beautiful view of the cool ocean, which by the way, as I was saying earlier, that ocean water, it's mesmerizing. So being high up there with my friend Isaiah and I, it was really cool because we had like a little moment to chit chat, be by ourselves, and just take in the real nice scenery that is Florida Keys. But aside from parasailing, we went down and we took like really cool pictures on the beach. You know, of course, we had to flick it up so we could post it on Instagram and say, y'all, we in Key West living our best lives. And so I took really bomb pictures down there, y'all. I felt like a supermodel, whatever. After we took really cool pictures, we just went paddleboarding, which is really nice because to paddleboard, it's extremely hard. Like, we were trying sitting down, we tried it on our knees, we tried standing up, and when I tell you all of us failed epically, It was hard. And after we did some water activities, we went down to this really cool Mexican restaurant and we got fajitas. It was really nice once again to sit down with my friends and just eat. And of course I flicked it up a little bit before we went into the restaurant or whatever. I like literally changed into like a whole different outfit just to go eat there. But I was like, hey, listen, it's my birthday. I will not be caught seen in the same outfit twice that day, okay? Like I gotta change it up for these Key West folks. And the cool thing was when I took these pictures before I went into the restaurant, I posted them on my Instagram, right? And y'all, Fashion Nova commented on the picture. They were like, gorgeous, heart emoji. And I was like, yo, is this real? Like, is this happening? Fashion Nova just commented on my pic and they liked some of my pics too. Like, y'all, I wanted to faint. Real talk. Fashion Nova is one of my favorite brands ever. I love their clothes because right now I'm obsessed with crop tops and cool sunglasses and nice, like, jewelry necklaces. And Fashion Nova is just the place to go for a really nice, cool, affordable thing. So for them to recognize me, I was like, y'all, what? Are you about to slide into my DMs or whatever? You know, I don't have a problem with that. So after we got our fajitas, we walked around a little bit more on Duval Street and we got some milkshakes, which honestly, y'all, is my favorite little dessert ever. I am obsessed with milkshake, typically like Oreo milkshakes and also M&M milkshakes, y'all. Now I want a milkshake. Hold up. I'll be right back. But anyway, after we did that, we just headed back into the car to go down back to Miami. Like, it was a 4-hour drive once again. To be honest, Florida Keys at night, she's a little scary. Like, there were no lights on a lot of the streets, and then some of the streets had red lights. Like, me and my friends were like, is this the day that we died? Like, on Brianna's birthday? So, luckily, though, we made it out of there. And on the way back, it was, like, a really good conversation that we had. We were just talking about, like, relationships and just, you know, speaking to each other and giving each other advice. And it's just like, aw, this is honestly what friends are for. Like, I don't have much, so I don't really know. But, you know, at moments like this, I'm like, hey, I think this is what friends do. This is cool.
This is normal.
So yeah, after that, we all just headed on home. I dropped everybody off and I headed back to Mi Casa, where I just unwind, unpack my bag, and then celebrated the last couple of minutes of my birthday alone. All in all, I really want to say that I had like a really great birthday, you guys. Like, the day before my birthday, I did so many cool things with my family. Like, I went to breakfast, went to the Sky Museum, went to dinner, and the day on my birthday, I went to Key West, you guys. I was so happy to go. It is something definitely, like, if you live in Florida and you've never gone to the Key West, like, honey, you're not living. It should be on your bucket list for every single Floridian. It's something definitely I feel like everyone should experience. But I was so happy going there. I went to Key West, got some bomb breakfast, some bomb fajitas, went parasailing and did water sports. Like, it all in all was such a great and amazing birthday. I had so much fun. Like, this year, honestly, turning 21 was really great. I had an amazing time just, you know, hanging out and doing things that I genuinely like to do. So thank you guys for coming to my TED Talk. But alright guys, so that completes everything I did for my 21st birthday. I really want to thank you guys so much for watching my video. Please make sure y'all to like, comment, and subscribe to your girl's YouTube channel and turn that notifications bell on so you can be notified when I upload a brand new video. Also, please make sure to add your girl on Instagram at Brianna_Calixte and add your girl on Snapchat as well at RedAndBlackPrincess. And also y'all, I am slowly trying to come back to Twitter, so if you want, add me on Twitter as well. You know, tweet me, let me know what's good, help me get my following up. But all right guys, thank you so much for watching, and hold up, it's not the end of the video. Y'all got a little clip that's coming, so you know, sit back. But for me, it's the end. All right, bye guys.
Free shot
for me. Oh my god.
That concludes Key West.